Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular 0 to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about data binding in Angular. In this video, I'm going to explain about directives. Directives in Angular can be defined as instructions in the DOM. Angular components are also directives, because through component, we are instructing Angular to place the HTML and TypeScript logic in the place of the selector. So components are also directives, but with a template. Apart from component, we have two types of inbuilt directives in Angular: structural directives, attribute directives. Structural directives are directives, those modify the DOM. Some of the most common structural directives are ngIf, ngFor, and ngSwitch. Let me explain in detail using an example program. I have created a new Angular program using CLI. I have also started the server and opened the application in a browser. Now I am deleting the existing code in app component HTML and adding a container div and then a heading followed by row and column divs. Inside that, I am creating two buttons, approve and reject. We can see this. If we add Bootstrap to our application, we can apply styles easily. So let's see how we can add Bootstrap. I'm opening the command prompt, stopping the server using Ctrl C, and then installing Bootstrap using npm. npm install Bootstrap. Now Bootstrap has been installed. We shall see this in node modules folder. We have the Bootstrap CSS here. We need to add this path to angular.json. That's it. Bootstrap has been added and now we can start the server again. If I refresh, we can see the Bootstrap styles for container, row and column classes have been applied. Now let me add some styles for buttons using Bootstrap classes. And then in app component CSS, I'm adding some styles, padding 50 pixel, text align center, and a height of 2000 pixel to the container class, and a margin of 40 pixel to the H2 class, a width of 130 pixel and margin 20 pixel to the button class. Let's preview once. Now I wanted to show different messages on clicking these buttons. So I'm creating another column div. Inside that, I'm creating two paragraph tags. In the first tag, I'm having the text, "Your application has been approved." And in the second paragraph, I'm having the text, "Sorry, your application has been rejected." In preview, we can see both the text. Let me also increase the font size. Okay, now I want to show the message based on the button click. For that, I am adding click event to the buttons and calling a function approve. For the approve button, I am passing the value as true, and for the reject button, I am passing the value as false. And in the TypeScript component, let me create the approve function. And I am also creating a boolean variable isApproved and defaulting it to false. Inside the approve function, I'm getting the value from HTML component and assigning to this variable. Coming back to the HTML, I'm adding a structural directive ngIf. Please note here the syntax of any structural directive will be starting with a star. This is mandatory and this is to inform Angular that this directive is going to modify the DOM. And ngIf accepts any variable or expression which gets transformed to a boolean. So for the first paragraph, I'm having is approved, and for the second paragraph, I'm having a not or negation operator followed by is approved. Now we can see only one p tag is visible now, and on clicking the other button, the other message is visible. This is how we can use ngIf to hide and show any DOM elements dynamically. Now let's move to ngFor. Using ngFor, we can loop through an array and display that in the HTML. For that, I'm creating an array called numbers. In numbers array, I'm having the numbers from 1 to 10. Now in HTML, we can display these numbers one by one inside p tags. For that, we can use ngFor. ngFor is also a structural directive, and so we should not forget to add star. In ngFor, we can loop through the array like let number of numbers. Here, numbers is the array we have declared in the TypeScript component, and number is the variable which we can use it in HTML. And inside p tag, using string interpolation, we can display the number. We can see all the numbers are listed one by one. In ngFor, we can also access an index and use it if needed. Index always starts from 0. So if we need to start this from 1, we can increment it before displaying. This is how we can use ngFor to loop through an array and display them in the HTML. Next, let's move to ngSwitch. Using ngSwitch, we can switch between different DOMs based on some value. To explain this, let me create an input element which accepts only number. And I'm binding this to a variable called lucky number using ngModel directive. Remember, we need to import the forms module, otherwise this will not work. And in the TypeScript component, I'm creating that variable and assigning it to 0. Back in HTML, I'm creating a column div in which I'm using the ngSwitch property and binding that to the lucky number variable using property binding. Inside that, let me create p tags to display words. I can switch one of these words using ngSwitch case. For the case statement, we need to add star. Also, assigning the values from 1 to 5. And then we can also default something using ngSwitch default directive. Now, if we preview, based on user input, the words change. And if user enters other than the value matching any of the case statement, it displays the default value. This is how we can use ngSwitch directive. Before we move on to our next topic, I would like to explain another concept in structural directives. For that, let me copy this code. So here we are seeing all the numbers listed, but I wanted to display only the even numbers. We know that we can use ngIf to filter only even numbers like this, but we cannot use two structural directives in the same DOM. When we use ngIf, regardless of the value, whether it is going to be true or false, we get an error saying we cannot use multiple structural directives in the same DOM. So what we can do is we can wrap this in another span, and in this span we can use ngIf like this. Now we can see only the even numbers are getting listed. Next, let me explain attribute directives with examples. I will explain attribute directives in my next video. In the meantime, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you.